Я. Это национальность его.
Я знаю.
С помощью телескопа мы наблюдаем
спектром. Gigaelectron volts, very big spike, much bigger than Higgs boson spectrum. And Bazhutov predicted the presence of this particle with the mass of 200 gigaelectron.
Wow.
He predicted this.
Right.
Can't explain conclusion with this particle that it may be stable and consistent very low level. And this particle, as I think, Yuri, make the transmutation.
Wow, okay. So it, this is his ecton particle? No.
No.
Erzion.
Erzion. Sorry. Yeah. Erzion. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Bazhutov supposed that this is separate particle. Ecton is a complex electron.
So it's the Erzion is a unique particle.
Unique particle. This particle has new quark. Mirror with new quark that comes with cosmic rays.
Okay, and so the energy level is 200 gigaelectron volts.
Yes.
Okay. Bazhutov proposed this idea during more than 25 years. And nobody don't like to hear.
It's fanatically process. Yuri, so fanatically that other men
not intend to take into account the existence of this particle.
And so what do the LHC owners think this 200 gigaelectron volt peak is? Do they have a reason for it?
A reason for what?
The 200 gigaelectron volt peak. What do they say it is?
Yes. This particle
produced by this particle. Mm. This particle some
204 approximately gigaelectron
volts. A little bit more than 204.
More heavy than
240. Yes, and I'd like to emphasize that that it was obtained on the experiments
for the Higgs boson.
After Higgs boson,
yeah,
in the experiment of Big Collider, the unique particles with the value very, very, very close to the prediction by Bazhutov.
So, what made him consider this particle?
Что ему he made что ему позволило сделать вывод об этом?
Bazhutov in the first time of your working test the cosmic rays, and cosmic rays have the problem to pass the intensity. 30 years ago.
And what was he doing that work for? He was just studying atmospheric interactions from cosmos.
Problem with
где генерируется?
Erzion come from galactic.
Right.
It's not generated in the atmosphere. It comes from the space.
And is it influenced by gravity?
Это похоже на гравитацию.
No,
no, no, it, it, it's different.
No, is the particle itself influenced by gravity?
Very low intensity.
And is the particle neutral?
The density of this radiation is very, very small.
Okay, and is it neutral?
Difference. Have neutral and
several types of this particle. Mm-hmm. Several
and,
types.
Have
this particle combination of quark.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Combination of quark. There is a combination, neutral combination from the quark, mm-hmm. and this is a electrically charged. Neutral electrically charged combination.
Mm-hmm.
Minus
positive and neutral. There's three versions, yeah. Is it?
Cosmic Erzion is neutral.
Neutron, but it can convert to Erzion with minus charge.
Right.
Converts into
atmosphere.
Into atmosphere and into Bazhutov put the special barrels with filled with the
salt.
Salt. In this salt,
potassium.
In the potassium.
Carbon.
Potassium carbonate.
Sodium, potassium, and in this material, the neutral rays of this particle generates into charged particle. Mm-hmm. Into charge.
You know Bill Collis?
Yes.
Bill Collis is adept of Bazhutov Erzion theory. Bill Collis helped Bazhutov and also construct the sum of the theoretical model for Erzions. Answer Bill Collis, and you tell about Erzion more than I.
Right. He understands it more than.
Request Bill Collis, and he.
Yeah, yeah.
He gave,
I like Bill Collis. He's a very affable guy, congenial. Yeah. As the Italian would say, sympathetic.
Ну жаль, что только вот Билл Коллинз и никто больше не поддерживал Бажутова в этом направлении.
It's a very interesting idea, but Бажутов.
The human beings has such a feature that every new idea
is rejected.
Rejected, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's very strange.
Yeah.
Maybe this is way to revive in the very changing world.
Survive, yeah, yeah.
Survive,
yeah.
In the very changing.
Like if someone offers you some food, you want to see someone else taste it first. There is a psychological situation where, like, if someone asks a question in a room, and there might be 100 people in the room, and 20 people know the answer, but no one wants to put their hand up and give the answer. But when one, or a suggestion, when one person puts their hand up, all of the other people start suggesting. This is why I was trying to get across in my presentation that look for things, when you find things, share them, even if you think they're nonsense. For me, the most important thing that was shared was in the last maybe 15 years, for my understanding, probably, was S.V. Adamenko just mentioning in an interview about the 6 times that he observed this structure in his targets absorbing the primary ions. He was firing in the primary ions, and
he says,
yes, I I have very interesting experiment with bismuth salt. But
he made an experiment with bismuth.
With bismuth, yeah.
Bismuth in the capacitor.
Uh-huh.
Inside of capacitor,
with
very high voltage of the capacitor. Not very high, but 30, Dim, сколько у тебя там? 30 kilovolts?
20 kilovolts.
Right.
20 kilovolts was only. And after that, during more than 1 year, very strange particles going out from this.
I think bismuth is one of the most beautiful elements.
Really. Yes, it's an end of stable element.
Yes.
Bismuth.
Well, technically it's unstable, but you would have to wait till more than the end of the universe.
10 degrees.
A very, very long time.
Very, very long, very long time. Yeah. You understand Russian, I believe. he knows Russian well, but
yes.
But
no, I live in the Czech Republic, so there's a lot of
Czech Republic.
There's a lot of common words. So I
говорю, что много общих слов в чешском.
Some similar words. So if I know the subject and I can hear some Russian, I can pick up some of the context, but not a lot. I have to work very hard with my brain.
As we also have training on English, but here second day we tell something. And the
maybe you see that our English became better and better.
Yeah.
Well, two weeks, and we will speak more or less.
I think so. I think probably you often read research that is in English, and maybe you work hard at trying to read that. So it's in your head, but you don't know it's in your head, maybe. My problem is I'm not very good at reading the Cyrillic, so I have to translate. So at least you can, the symbols are simple in English.
No, one. Yes, you're right. I think about our, with Dima, our experiments every day, every hour, and every minute.
Yeah.
It's very strange, but I can't don't think about that.
So sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night and I'm thinking about experiments or research that I've read. And my partner says to me, "What's going on?" I says, "I have to get out of bed and I have to write things down, because if I don't write it down, I forget them." Some of my best work is done when I'm asleep, not really asleep, on the edge of asleep.
My best things going into my head is just after my wake up.
Yeah.
Just after my
right,
wake up.
Right, yeah.
During 10 minutes, maybe.
But I have that in the middle of the night. I just wake up in the middle of the night and I have to write things down.
First time, I wake up two times. First, on the 4 a.m.
Right.
And after that, at 8 a.m.
So is that when you get your ideas for your experiments?
Yes, and my ideas, most interesting ideas, goes to head into first wake up in the 4 a.m. hour.
Yeah.
thank you.
It's okay. Thank you. It's been a real pleasure. Thank you for sharing these samples as well. I really appreciate that.